start with this nuclear overhauser effect. So this is the experiment which we do for NMR spectrum, in NMR spectrum, for the differentiation between the geometric isomerism as well as stereochemical isomers, means optically active or enantiomers. See, what is the use of, and when we use this, question is, when we use NOE experiment and what is the effect, what is the benefit? See, so there are many reasons. Many times we found that the coupling constant is unable to help us to determine the geometry of the molecule or stereochemistry of the molecule or conformation in the molecule. So in such cases, nuclear Overhauser effect is a very helpful experiment, very helpful technique. What is the principle of this technique is, what you do, you select two protons from the molecules, or you select two groups in the molecule which are near to each other in the space. So what we can say, NOE is the space phenomena. The NOE experiment is the space phenomena. While coupling constant, it is what? It is the bond phenomena, through bond. And this NOE takes place through space. So if two groups are, they are near to each other, if two groups, they are near to each other, so there this phenomena work very well. Now see, what is the principle we can say? See, in a very simple concept, select the two groups, they can be two protons, they can be two different groups, they can be one proton and different group. And you, out of these two, you irradiate one of the group. One of the groups, you irradiate by second radio wave frequency. You can fit it, it is provided with the instrument. So what will happen? When you provide the second radio wave to the another group, so what will happen? That will not appear in the NMR spectrum, and the another group will appear in the spectrum, but slightly more intense. Okay, but a small few percent, not double times intense, very few percent, and you can identify it, right? And it appears in the form of peak in the NMR spectrum. And if we find that due to the radiation, double irradiation, there is a increase in the intensity of a peak, therefore we can say that is NOE is working our for our compound. Now see, consider this example, perform an reaction. Suppose this molecule undergoing elimination reaction, and suppose this compound is formed, mechanism is very different, and this undergoes rearrangement, but our discussion is not for that. This is the compound will form, but there is one more chance, and suppose it is that. Suppose this is the chance also. So, but which is the major product, or which one will be formed after rearrangement, which will be the product which is formed in this reaction? So we cannot use here the coupling constant idea. Why? Because coupling constant will not work. Coupling constant will not work in this case. Because how do you find the coupling constant? Because only one proton is there, there is no neighboring proton. So in such molecules, nuclear Overhauser effect, NOE experiment is a very much helpful. Now see, so let us apply the NOE to this problem, which is now we are going to discuss. Now see, those protons which are here in this piperidine ring, these two protons and these two protons, we will show them in color. And you irradiate them, you select these protons and this proton also. So we have selected this proton and these two protons, okay, fine. Select this and these two protons and these two protons. So two sets are selected. This is one set and one set. And what you do, here also, same. You irradiate it. And if we irradiate this double irradiation, peaks for this will be disappear, and these peaks will be become somewhat intense. If it become intense, so we have to take decision. So what will be the structure out of this two? So if there is an increase in the intensity of proton, alkene proton, this, which is the product then? Compound is alkene, means that will be the product because it is in this proximity of this, near to this nitrogen or this CH2 group. This is what the nuclear Ohr-Hauser effect. See here, experiment, we'll perform the experiment. Now see, I now irradiate the black protons, both CH2 group, left and right side black protons. Irradiate it. When we do double irradiation, so peak will be not available in that spectrum for this black protons. But what about the fate of green proton? The green proton signal intensity enhanced, and then if there is an enhancement in the green proton intensity, it means that they are near to each other. Black and green protons must be close in space. That is the important point. So alkene must be E. Means this is the product. This product will form in which the hydrogen and black hydrogen created, they are in the C space. So this is the application of NOE. Okay, right. Further, NOE can be extended for the determination of three-dimensional stereochemistry of the molecule. It was the geometric isomerism. This is the example of geometric isomerism. Let us go for the three-dimensional structure discussion. Now see, consider this example. We have this reactant and we are performing the reduction of this molecule. When we perform the reduction of this molecule, two products going to form. Alcohols will definitely, but which alcohol will be the form? Or suppose only one alcohol is formed, but our aim is to determine this OH position is above the plane, below the plane, or with respect to this H spatially. With respect to this H, how to find out? So irradiate this proton, only one proton you irradiate, or you irradiate this also, no problem. But let us irradiate this one. When you irradiate this one, so if this proton, red proton, near to this H in space, definitely this proton intensity, this proton signal intensity will increase. If this proton is not in near space for this, no increment will be observed. But you see, NOE observed for this proton, for green proton. It means that these two protons, they are near to each other, and that is possible only when they are cis to each other. Very simple idea. So hope you understand this concept. Extend this idea to further to next molecule. So now see, this is the result of the experiment, that two protons, they are cis to each other. Okay, cis to each other. Fine. Let us go for this molecule. Now see, our aim is to find out that on performing the Bayer-Wieser reaction, whether this product are formed or not. Okay, or which product is going to form. Okay, right. Now see, here the colored are not so much clear, but we will try to understand this in a simple spectrum. Okay, see now. See, stereochemistry, we have to find out when we perform this product which is formed by the Bayer-Wieser oxidation. So this product is formed, or oxygen insertion takes place from this side. That is our aim to understand, to get the idea. Okay. Or we can say, this is the product suppose, this is the product suppose, this is the product, final product suppose, and we have seen this before. So we have two questions. This ethyl group, now you were showing down, and here is the hydrogen, endo-exo. You might have heard this. This is the hydrogen, and ethyl is down, is an endo product, is an endo product. One chance can be ethyl can be here, X will be here. So this is the first point. The first point is what? This ethyl position is where? Endo or exo? One point. Second point, 1, 2, 3, and have one proton here. Which proton belongs to which signal? That is a question. Or which signal belongs to which proton? Because almost protons are the same. This aliphatic compound. So what do we do now? We have two questions before us. Number one question, orientation of ethyl group, where it is situated, is the endo here like this as shown, or exo? One. Second point, this proton, and here one more proton, where, how to correlate their signals? That is the point. Now see them. Irradiate, what to do? This CH2 protons. This is the diastereotopic proton, no problem. we have to tell about the geometry also, or orientation of this proton, or stereochemistry of this proton. Okay, now see. Now see, when you irradiate, labeling is okay, no problem. You can label it green, yellow, orange, no problem. But have a idea of this molecule in your, make a picture of this molecule, okay, in your thinking, and then think about it. See, what to do? This H2O of ethyl group, let us irradiate it. See here, first irradiate this H2, and you irradiate this CH3, and observe the other protons. See what is going on. First, you irradiate this one CH2, then CH3 irradiate, and observe the intensity of the peaks of protons which are around it. Okay, right. Then after that, you irradiate any one proton. We will see it. That proton will be appear here now. See. What to do? First, irradiate this CH2. Then irradiate CH3. This two are interconversion, right? No. Then irradiate CH3. This methyl. So we can perform simultaneously or different time also. First, in the first case, first phase irradiate this, both are same. Second phase irradiate this. Now irradiate this. So see here now. So what will happen? We know when we irradiate. So what do you think? When you irradiate this, there will be increase in intensity of green or black. Yes or no? Yes. Because according to NOE principle, only those protons which are near in the space of the irradiated group, that only those protons show increment in their intensity of their signals. So when you irradiate this CH2, this H intensity will be increased. Fine? Yes. Very good. And when we irradiate this hydrogen, this intensity of this proton will increase, while not for this one. When you irradiate this hydrogen, intensity of this H and CH2 will be increased. Simple idea. When you irradiate this CH2, this will be increased, while this will not. Why? Because CH2 is far up from this. This is up. Ye niche hai, ye upar hai. This is up. So this CH2 irradiation has no impact on this proton. But this green and black will increase their intensity because they are near to this CH2. Are you getting the point? Yes. Next point. What do you do now? You irradiate green. When you irradiate this green, so green, what will do? It will increase the intensity of this H and this CH2, because, and not for this H, because this H is exo and H is endo. So understand this idea, and let us make the conclusion. Enhancement of a signal of a black, yellow and green were observed. See, when you irradiate this, so this and this will increase. When you irradiate methyl, iska bhi badh jayega, right? Kyunki iske range in nazdeek hai. Getting the point? Yes. If you irradiate these two, if you irradiate this first of all, CH2, these two increase. Second case, irradiate methyl, this will increase because near to this one. So these two protons which are on this side will be increased in their intensity on irradiation of CH2 and CH3, isn't it? Yes. While this will remain as it is, its intensity showing no change. The ethyl group can rotate rapidly on the NMR time scale. So this will be there, right? This sentence is not so much important. This first sentence is important. Now see second part. NOE effect to the yellow, but not to the brown proton is particularly seen. See, our aim is to think about it. Now this brown will not see, fine. See here. This brown proton will not show any effect from this ethyl. Why? Because they are far off. But this yellow proton definitely showing the enhancement due to the irradiation of this methyl. So very simple idea. Very simple. So confirm, ethyl is endo, not exo. Agar ye exo hota, to ye iska intensity badhti when you irradiate this one. Black ki nahi badhti, lekin black ka badh raha means ye endo hai, and therefore they are near to each other. Right? The position of ethyl group is clear now, right? Yes. Now see next point. sorry. Next point is what? Next point is, see now, if you irradiate this green proton, so whose stereochemistry is now clear? This proton, this orange proton increase in intensity, isn't it? Yes, that's all. And therefore we can say these two protons, they are exo and ethyl groups endo. Very simple. Fine. So this orange proton, yellow proton, and this brown proton. So brown proton shows no change in intensity because it is away from this green and this ethyl group, and therefore we can say that this is the structure of the compound. Fine. So hope you understand this idea, and you can ask the question on this, and if you.